An average is a number which represents a set of data. Firstly, we'll look at the mode. The mode of a set of data is the most commonly occurring value in that data set. It's the one that comes up the most. For example, if we look at this list of colors, the color that comes up the most is blue because it comes up 3 times, whereas all the other colors come up, all the other colors come up twice. So it comes up the most, it is the mode. We also call this the modal color. In this list of numbers, which obviously we'll more commonly see, the mode is 3, the modal value, because 3 comes up more than any of the other numbers. In this list of numbers, we have negatives, doesn't matter. The mode is minus 4.5. The mode has the advantage that we can use it for numbers, as we've seen here, and also for things like colors, so for discrete data. The mode has the advantage that it can be used for both numerical and categorical data, as we've seen. You know, we can use it for the numbers or for the colors, couldn't we? Problem is, sometimes there are multiple modes or no modes. So if we look here, in example A, 2 and 3 both come up the most, as in they come up more than 5 and 7. We can say that 2 and 3 are both modes. So we also like to work out something called the mean, and this is the preferred average for numerical data. And to work out the mean, we add up the values and we divide by how many values there are. For example, if we want to calculate the mean of 2, 3, and 4, I would just add up 2, 3, and 4. So that's 2 plus 3 plus 4, which is 5, 9. And we divide that by how many values there are, which is 3. So we have 9 over 3, which is 3. Next, we have 4 plus 5 plus 9 plus 4 plus 3. And we need to divide that by how many values there are, which is 5. So we have 9, 18, 25, 25 divided by 5, which is 5. For C, we do 12 plus 10 plus 0 plus 4 plus 2. And we have 5 values. That gives us 16, 26, 28 over 5. Which is going to be 5 3/5, or you could say 5.6. And lastly, we have 7 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 over 4. So we have 10, 14, 19 over 4, which is going to be 4 3/4, or 4.75. Here are some questions for you to try. Please pause the video now and have a go at them. And when you're ready for the answers, press play. Here are the answers. So we can see here that in each case, there's obviously only one mean, but it might be that there are no modes or there are multiple modes. If I want to work out the mean of this set of data, 2, 30, 50, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 4, we end up with 8.5. But if you look at the data, almost all of the values are below 8.5. So it's not really fair to say that 8.5 represents that data. We say that the outlier or anomaly or extreme value of 50 has affected the mean, and this is quite common. The mean is very heavily affected by outliers. So there's another kind of average that we need as well, which is the median. And this is not as affected by outliers. So when it comes to things like household incomes, the amount of money that a household takes in, we tend to use the median to do that on a national level because it's so subject to extreme values. There are some people who sadly don't have any money at all, or are homeless, and they're going to have a household income of 0. And there are other people at the very opposite end who have a very high household income. And because of these extreme values, we tend to use the median to work that out. So Let's work out the medians of these set of data. The median is just the middle value when you put the data in order, and I always tend to do it in ascending order. So if we look at the first example, the data is already in order. To find the middle, I cross off the ends and work my way in. And I can see that the middle value is 5, so that's our median. In the second set of values, we need to actually put them in order. So we have 7, 8, 10, 12, and 13. And again, cross off the ends to work our way in. And we have 10 as the median. Finally, we need to again put our data in order. 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. Cross off as we go into the middle. But this time we see there are two values in the middle, 4 and 5. So to find the median, we need to go halfway between 4 and 5. And a way of doing this we should know is 4.5, but we could also add up 4 and 5 to get 9, and then halve it, which will also give us 4.5. So the median in C is 4.5. Here are some questions for you to try. Please pause the video now and have a go at them. And when you're ready for the answers, press play. Here are the answers. The range is not an average, but it's a measure of spread. It's a way to measure how spread out our data is. The range is simply the biggest value in a set of data, take away the smallest value. So if I wanted to calculate the range of this set of numbers, I would identify that 27 is the biggest, and the smallest value is 2, so I just need to do 27 take away 2, which is 25, and that would be our range. We use the averages to compare two distributions. For example, Ken and Louis play football. Over 10 games, the mean number of goals per game scored by Ken was 2.4, and for Louis was 2.8. The range of Ken's scores was 1, and the range of Louis' scores was 3. We're asked to comment on the two players. Because Louis has a higher mean number of scores per game, we say that he scores more goals on average, but since the range of Ken's scores is lower, he is a more consistent player. Because if the range is lower, the data is less spread out. Here's a question for you to try. You need to calculate the statistics to help you. By calculating the mean and range of each player's score, comment on their performance in the last 5 games. Please pause the video now and have a go, and when you're ready for the answers, press play. Here are the answers. Alice's mean goals is 2 goals per game. The range of Alice's goals is 5. The mean of Betty's goals is 1.8 goals per game, and her range is 2. We say that Alice had a higher number of goals on average per game, but Betty had a lower range of scores, so that means that she's a more consistent player.